Welcome to my classroom. Today we're going to go over combining like terms. So what does it mean to combine like terms? Well, we can add, we can subtract them only and only if we have like terms. So what makes like terms? So let's look at example number one. Example number one, we have 2x plus 3x plus x. In this case, you need to look at your variables. First, you need to make sure they are all the exact same variable. So yes, we have nothing but x's, so we can combine those. Then we need to look at their exponent, their power. They need to have the exact same power for us to be able to combine them, because that would make them like terms. So we talked about it in the past, a variable with no exponent has an invisible exponent of a 1. So we have a 1 here. Since it doesn't have anything, it doesn't mean 0, it means 1. And this one also means 1. Therefore, we can combine all these terms together. So we would have 5x to the first. This power doesn't add up. You only add up the coefficients and numbers in front of the variables. And now, this x, we talked about in the past, has an invisible coefficient of a 1. So we would add these coefficients. Variable stays the same. The power stays the same. Do not add up the powers to a 2. In addition, the power stays the same. So your answer would be 6x or 6x to the first power. Let's look at number 2. So again, it has to follow the same conditions. Do we have the same variable? Yes, we do. Do we have the same exponent? Well, we have a 2 here, but we know that over here we have a 1. So since these are not exactly the same, they're similar, right? Because it's the same variable, but they're not exactly the same. They do not have the same exponent, so we cannot combine the 3 and the 5. And this is your simplest form. You have to leave it as 3x squared plus 5x. Now we look at the next one. We have 2x to the second power plus 5 plus 1 plus 4x to the second power. You cannot combine all of them, but you do have some terms that are alike. So we can combine your 2 and your 4, that would be 6, but x squared stays as x squared. Remember, you do not add the powers. Then right here, we have two constants, the 5 and the 1. They're both just numbers, no variables, so we can combine 5 plus 1, and that would be plus 6. And that would be your final answer. You cannot combine this and this and make it 12x squared. You cannot do that because this doesn't have the same variable, and obviously since there's no variable, you can't even check the exponent. So these are not like terms, and you would just leave it like that. Well, that was your math lesson for today. Subscribe. If you have any questions, any comments, put them right there. Make sure you like. Bye.